We have to see how to write a test cases in manual testing by using Excel sheet. In today's video, we can see the Amazon website another module, which is cart page module. In previous video, we already covered the most of the modules of this e-commerce website. So all other videos are available in the description box. Do check it out. And let's begin with today's video. First of all, this is the template of test cases. So this template will be available in the description box. I'll share with you a Google Drive link. You can access that drive and then download the template from there. So first of all, you have to mention the project name, which is Amazon website, then your module name, which is cart page module, then created by, that means of who write all these test cases, that writer name will be there, then creation date, then your executor name, execution date, all are the basic things you have to provide. Then there are compulsory as well as most important things or most important fields, which are scenario ID, then scenario description, test case ID, preconditions, steps to execute, then your expected result, then your actual result, then the status, comments, all are the things you have to mention there. First of all, what are the scenario ID and test case ID? Scenario ID and test case ID are the basic identification. So there is no need to provide the names which are available in the video or which are available in the books. You can provide the names as per your choice because it is the basic identification. Then scenario description means a particular scenario. You have to test that scenario. That scenario will be described here. Then the precondition means the condition you have to mention or you have to compulsory fulfill before start the execution of your test case, that precondition. Then step to execute means the input provided before execution of the test case, that input should be steps to execute. Then expected result means once we complete the testing, then what should be the result we all expected. That result means expected result, and actual result means once you provide the input, process that input, then that output means the actual result. And status means the whenever your expected result and actual result are exactly similar, then the status will be passed. That means your system will be successfully pass in this testing, otherwise it will be fail. And once the system will be fail in this testing, then your developer will be do changes according to your concern or according to your need. So all are the basic fields. Let's begin with the first scenario, which is verify that when user clicks on add to cart button, then product should be moved to cart. So we have to test whenever we click on add to cart button, then the product should be moved to cart or not. We have to verify that, and for that you have to search a particular product, and for once you search the product, then you have to select a single product, and once you select a single product, then you have to check our condition, and for that you have to provide some steps, which are execution steps. First of all, you have to open the system. Open the system means you have to open your browser, then you have to search amazon.com and then log into website. And once you log into website, then that system will be open for your use, and then you can search a product and select a single product and just scroll down that product. Then there is a button add to cart, and once you click on add to cart button, then expect result will be product should be added into the cart. And we all know the expected result and actual result are exactly similar, because once we click on add to cart button, then that product should be added into the cart. And here our expected result and actual result are similar, and that's why the status of this testing will be passed. Then the second scenario, which is verify that the user will be able to continue shopping after adding item to cart. That means once we add a single product into the cart, then we will be able to do shopping continuously or not. We have to verify that, and for that you have to open the system. Once you open the system, then you have to search a product and add to cart a product. And once you add to cart a product, then the expected result will be shopping should be continue. And we all know the expected result and actual result are similar, because once we add a single product into the cart, and then we can again navigate to our shopping, because we continue with shopping, and expected result and actual result are similar, and that's why the status of this testing will be passed. Then the third scenario, which is verify that quantity of item should be incremented if user adds same item into the cart again. That means if first of all we add a single product, particular single product into the cart, and then again we add same product into that same cart, then the quantity of that product should be incremented or not. We have to verify that, and for that you have to open the system, then you search particular product and then add to cart that product, and once again add to cart that product, and how many times you can add to cart that product, then the expected result that item number should be incremented when we add new product in same cart. That means if we add a pen first of all in the cart, then again we add same pen into the cart, then that number or that count of that pen should be 2, not 1. So this is the expected result, and actual result also similar, because the quantity of product should incremented, and that's why the status of this testing will be passed. Then the fourth scenario, which is verify that total amount of all product in the cart are displayed to user. That means how many products into the cart, that total amount of that product should be displayed to user, and for that you have to search a product. This is the precondition. And what are the steps to execute? You have to open the system, you have to search a particular product, then add to cart that product. All are the conditions. Once you fulfill, then the expected result is amount of all products should be displayed. And we all know the expected result and actual result are similar, because how many products into the cart, that amount of that products will be added or will be sum, and that sum should be displayed to user, and that's why the status of this testing is passed. Then the next scenario, which is verify that the amount displayed to user should be include the taxes and shipping charges. That means whenever we can add add a product into the cart, then tax as well as shipping charges as per the location we have to display to user, and this will be happen or not, we have to verify that. And for that you have to open the system. That means you have to log into Amazon, then you have to search product and add to cart item into the product. Then shipping charges and taxes should be added into the total amount. This is the expected result and actual result also as expected, and that's why status of this testing is passed. Then the another, that means this number scenario, which is verify that user should not be able to add item in cart beyond a certain limit. That means once you exceed a certain limit, then you cannot add any product into the cart, and this will be happen or not, we have to verify that. And for that you can search a particular product, add to cart a product, then again you can continue with your shopping, and once you exceed a particular limit, then that product should not be added into the cart. And this is the expected result, and expected result and actual result are similar, and that's why the status of this testing will be passed. But if here the product should be added after a certain limit, then expected result and actual result are not similar, and at that time your testing of this particular scenario will be fail, not a pass. So this is the sixth scenario. Then the seventh scenario, which is verify that when user clicks on remove from cart button, the item should be removed from cart or not. That means if we click on remove the item from cart remove button, then the item should be removed or not, we have to verify that. And for that you have to open the system and go to cart, and then remove a particular product from cart, and for that you have to click on remove button, remove from cart. So once you do all of the things or all of the steps are executed, then product should be removed from cart. This is the expected result, and expected result and actual result are exactly similar, and that's why status of this testing will be passed. Then the eighth scenario, which is verify that user should be able to apply coupons or vouchers at checkout from cart. That means whenever the cart will be loaded and you can check from this cart, that means you have to pay the bills of that products or you have to place your orders, then the coupons or vouchers will be applied or not. We have to verify that. And for open the system and some particular coupons or vouchers, then what should be happen or what will user should be able to add the, that coupons and vouchers. So expected result and actual result are similar, that's why the status of this testing will be passed. Then the next scenario, which is verify that item in cart should be present if user log out or log in again. That means if you log in, if you log out from Amazon and then again you can log in, then whenever you first log in, then you can add particular items into the cart and then you can log out. And once you can log in, then that same login, then your items are present into the cart or not. We have to verify that. And for that, you have to open the system. You can just log out or log in from the system and then click on the product, click the product or click the cart and then check your product of first login should be available or not. And the expected result is product should be present into the cart, and actual result also as similar, because if you log out from the cart and before log out, you can add some product into the cart and then again you can log in from similar login, that means username and password, then you can show all other products before logout. You can add it that into the cart, and that's why the status of this testing will be passed. And all about this cart page testing, I hope you understood how many scenarios are generated for this cart page or how to test that scenarios. And if this video is little bit helpful for you, please do like to this video, also share with your friends and family members, and do subscribe if haven't, and also hit the bell icon for such new videos, because whenever I upload any videos, then you can got the first notification of that videos, so you never miss any updates from my side. And if you like this video, please let me know in the comment section. Any suggestions, please let me know in the comment section, as well as you can suggest more topics for the videos. I'll definitely make sure to do the videos on that topic also. For watching this video, thank you so much and stay tuned for next video.